Dear student, today I will discuss about the spectral behavior of spectral reflectance characteristic of the soil, dry bare soil and water body. In my previous class, I already explained you spectral reflectance of healthy vegetation, which is one of the important part of common natural objects. So basically, when you are talking about, because the soil characteristic always vary from one place to the another place. When we move from one place, in somewhere you can see black soil, in somewhere you can see red soil, in somewhere you can see yellow soil. So it's the characteristic will be changed from the change in the topography, change in the place. So spectral reflectance is basically influenced by the presence of moisture content, texture, surface roughness, iron oxides, organic matter content, and these factors are complex variable and interrelated. Because when we are talking about in some soil, there is a high moisture content. So it doesn't mean always the moisture contents may be high in that particular area. Because when some of the weather has been changed and the area is not receiving any high amount of rainfall, sufficient amount of rainfall, then further in that particular soil, the moisture content will be less. In some way you can see the presence of organic matter content. But because of some phenomena, some characters change in some characters, weather, you can see the organic matter contents will be changed. So again, spectral behavior will be changed. So that kind of characteristic can easily identify when we draw the spectral reflectance curve. And then various ground-based methods are available, like spectrometer, radiometers, through which we can easily draw this kind of spectral reflectance curve. And that is very helpful to just identify about the health of the soil, characteristic of the soil. So, when we compare the spectral reflectance of soil with vegetation, so we can find some kind of similarity. In this spectral reflectance of the soil, it also show the less peak and valley variations. We can also see here kind of peak and valley configurations. But in comparison to the vegetation, the amount of absorption and reflectance will comparatively will be less. The reason is because their behavior of the vegetation is different. The behavior of the characteristic of the soil will be different. But the when we compare about the reflectance and absorption behavior, so there we can find some kind of similarity. So moisture in the soil will decrease its reflectance as with vegetation. This effect is the greatest in the water absorption band. When we compare with the spectral reflectance of the vegetation, we can find the high amount of absorption in this area, and it is because of the presence of moisture content in the leaf. That's why this absorption at 1.45 micrometer, 1.9 micrometer, 2.7 micrometer, it is only because of the presence of water or moisture in the vegetation, and that's why this band is called water absorption band. In the same way, we can see the kind of absorption, small, less absorption in this particular wavelength, and that's why this is also called, this is also called water absorption band. So when we are talking about the clay soil, clay have hydroxyl absorption bands at about 1.4 and 2.2 micrometer. So when we identify the different type of soil, clay having high hydroxyl bands, and at about 1.4 to 2.20 micrometer, this kind of absorption or valley can be identified. And the presence of iron oxide decreases. And suppose there is a soil in which we can identify some amount of iron oxides. So because of the presence of iron oxides, it decreases the reflectance in the visible portion. So if we go on some area where we can identify high amount of iron oxide in the soil, so in those area when we are identify the spectral behavior, spectral reflectance curve, we can, when we just draw a spectral reflectance curve by some radiometer, spectrometer, we can found the spectral reflectance characteristic will be less in those area. Soil moisture content is strongly related to the soil texture. So if we can see there is some soil where the moisture content is comparatively high, so what we can see, its textural behavior will be changed. Its textural characteristic will be changed. So if the we can see in some soil where the moisture is very high, so soil texture will be comparatively less. When we are talking about some fine soil where the moisture is comparatively less in those areas, so its textural characteristic will be changed. So coarse sandy soil are well drained, low in moisture content, and refracted well. And when we are talking about to those soil where the characteristic is just to drain out the when it is just exposed with some water, it easily drain the water, or suppose it not easily drain the amount of water, so its behavior will be changed. So when the coarse sandy, when we are talking about the coarse sandy soil, which is basically well drained in nature, so low in moisture content and hence reflect well. When you are talking about the poorly drained soil like clay loam, that this is the poorly drained soil, so it fine texture soil while generally have low reflectance. So in the absence of water, but this we are talking about to those soil where the moisture content is comparatively very less. So what will happen, there is a reverse tendency, and coarse texture soil reflects poor and fine texture soil comparatively well. So this is all about the spectral reflectance curve of dry bare soil. In my next class, I will explain you about the spectral behavior or spectral reflectance of water body. Thank you.